And into the game now for the Seattle Seahawks comes Jon Kitna. Kitna went to school at Central Washington, so he's a local boy in a way, but he really made his mark this spring. He played in the World League. He played for the Barcelona Dragons. In fact, he was the MVP of the World Bowl game, the championship game.
Guy threw for 401 yards or something in that game. He had a 22 touchdown season.
What kind of numbers in Little League is that?
Well, a chance where the World League really got this guy jump started.
So Kitna throws on first down. It's caught by Oscar Gray. So Kitna should be in a way in midseason form, because here's a guy who just stopped playing in a regular season about a month ago.
And he's involved in a competition for the third quarterback spot with that guy, Gino Toretta.
One of those memorable moments with all the Hall of Famers there last night or yesterday afternoon. Got a chance to meet a lot of these guys, and you know, it's a moment that I've been looking forward to for a long, long time.
Here's Broussard taking it up to the 34.
A lot of people got a chance to meet him for the first time here.
What, John Henry Johnson, Charlie Taylor.
Pretty good guys.
We'll give the ASU guys their due.
This booth,
everybody in San Diego heard that, Mike.
Yeah,
everybody heard it.
Now, that's how I got the handicap. They gave it to me.
I'll tell you, if you're an 8 in California, you're a 2.
Mike Haynes, fabulous career with the Patriots and with the Raiders. After graduating from ASU, and today goes into the Hall of Fame. And Jon Kitna takes off here. Kitna leading the team on a nice march down the field with a lot of help from Steve Broussard along the way. After getting sacked and having that fumble coughed up and turned into a touchdown, Jon Kitna trying for a little redemption on this drive, and so far so good.
Moves around pretty well too, does this former star of the World League.
First down for Seattle at the 20-yard line.
I hate when people say they're an 8 handicap.
Yeah.
I don't mind them saying it. I just hate it when they are.
Here's Dean.
I got a feeling he is.
I don't mind an 8 who says he's an 8. I hate the 18 who says he's an 8.
Vice versa. The case.
I hate that guy that lays it on you. Meanwhile, the Seahawks trying to lay one on the end zone, something they haven't done yet today.
Deems May, the former San Diego Charger, one of the new Seahawks, making the catch here. Second down and 3 now at the 13.
Getting a little early season change up at the line of scrimmage.
Dumped off underneath to Broussard, and he gets tackled immediately at the line of scrimmage. Pete Bursich is right there. It'll be third down, third and a deuce.
I think Kitna was trying to change off, and Ronnie Harris, his wide receiver who had single coverage to the left, just didn't get it.
Will be with us in the booth, Mr. Don Shula, one of the new enshrinees of Seattle on first down. Kitna retreats, throws, and a flag is down as Oscar Gray makes the catch. And Don, you've had such a wonderful career
at the Hall of Fame.
He's signed him to a new 4-year deal.
He was the franchise player. As the screen is set up, a little slow developing, and tipped but caught in a 3-yard gain for Broussard. Ben Hanks tipped it.
And there's part of the Miami connection.
Yeah.
Tez. Cortez Kennedy.
Well, he keeps playing the way he has, and if he could put another 4 or 5 years together, such as he's exhibited in the last 4 or 5, then it's another guy not making his last visit to Canton.
His last Pro Bowl was his 6th, so an impressive run for Cortez Kennedy. Mm-hmm. And we're keeping Todd Stussy awake, obviously. Here,
Kitna, and that's caught up at the 44-yard line by Tyree Davis. Broncos and the Dolphins from Mexico, a week from Monday night. Hit the throws, and that one is caught.
Upstairs here.
First down from the 32-yard line. Kitna's going to pack it in, show some scrambling ability, and dives out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Pickup of 5. Kitna, in addition to what he did through the air, rushed for 334 yards in the World League this year. So this guy with a good arm and mobility and trying to win that number 3 spot.
6'2", and as you can see, 217 pounds. He doesn't look that big, but That's a pretty good eye. Looks downfield, sees the coverage, pulls it down, gets yardage, as he's done a couple of times thus far in this quarter. And they're usually sitting out here with a fan on them, too.
Second and one. Kitna throws, and that's caught. It's enough for a first down. Oscar Gray, second-year man out of Arkansas, for the first down, with a minute and a half to play in the third period.
Kitna again, keeping it alive with a good throw for the first down.
Well, the Seahawks, we talked about it at the top as we watched the play again. Kitna picking up the two necessary yards. Paul Allen buying the team, and that will become official in all likelihood in about a week or so. And then with the referendum having passed, the funny thing about the Seahawks is they got the referendum passed, but it's still going to be about 6 years before they can move into the stadium.
D8 offense, 5 yard penalty, still first down.
They'll have to play three more years in the Kingdome. Then they're going to raise the Kingdome because they will have built the baseball stadium for the Mariners. They'll build a football stadium where the Kingdome was, and the Seahawks will probably play at Husky Stadium, so they're going to have to play five more seasons before getting into their new home park.
Yeah, it looks like 2 years at Husky Stadium there on the University of Washington campus, and a beautiful stadium right there on Lake Washington, and that has yet to be approved. That's not a foregone conclusion, but I can't imagine them playing anyplace else.
Tyree Davis makes the catch.
Fascinating, still the little children, the babies.
Third down and five. Jon Kitna throws, and that's caught. Touchdown, Tyree Davis.
Kitna with a good show.
So Kitna, who started the day by getting sacked and fumbling and giving up what turned out to be a touchdown off the fumble, has led two outstanding drives. Kitna is 14 of 14 for 105 yards.
And Randall was what, 11 of 11? Pretty good aerial show here today. Early in the season.
That must please Foge Fazio to no end. The defensive coordinator of the Vikings. He is not pleased.
Mm-mm. He is dripping, isn't he?
The Seattle dominated the line of scrimmage. By the fourth quarter, it was a full-fledged rout as Jon Kitna capped the night with his 4-yard TD pass to Oscar Gray, making it 34-6. Tonight, the Seahawks hope to keep things rocking with the appearance of their two highly touted rookies, offensive tackle Walter Jones and cornerback Sean Springs. In the preseason, second down and three. Jon still the ball. Could get the first himself and does as he scampers across the 50 and into 49er territory with the football just across the line. Jon Kitna, 17 of 20, 85% in the preseason. And of course, you know about his World League numbers when he was MVP in the World Bowl to get the victory for Barcelona. And just the numbers are there, but it's the confidence that has made such a difference for him playing this summer. And Sean Springs, he was terrific as a freshman. I remember watching him. It's third down and two. Kitna slides safely to the 25 and should have a first down. In fact, he does easily. Jon continues to run a good offense. He ran a 47-yard drive for that 32-yard field goal a moment ago.
And it's a bootleg. Jon comes around the corner, only needs 2 yards, so he pump fakes, knows that he can get the first down, get beyond the stick. Gets kneed. There's Dean May. He knows that he's not going to get the football. Cuts the legs out of Gary Plummer.
And you see a middle linebacker coming at you full steam. Get low, baby. First and 10 from the 25. Jon looking right all the way. Complete. Down to the 11-yard line is James McKnight, where he is finally stopped by former USC Trojan Mike Salmon, number 30.
Brother Tim. Angel baseball player throws that quick slant. They run the double slant on the right side. Jon Kitna makes an easy throw to the inside receiver. It's just pitch and catch, like playing out in the front yard.
Second down and six. They can get a first down. Looking for the touch pass left. Got it to James McKnight. Touchdown, Seattle. And the Seahawks take the lead on the nice touch lob into James McKnight.
We saw Jon Kitna last week show great ability to throw a touch pass on that touchdown to Oscar Gray. This time He just lays it up to the outside, allowing the ball to go over James McKnight's outside shoulder. Defensive back never saw the football.
Gets the first down, lost the football, still loose and out of bounds. Fortunate enough for Seattle. I don't think anybody had possession other than Deems May, so it'll still be Seattle ball. And it was forced by the backup safety, Derwin Gray.
And heads up play on the part of Jon Kitna to get rid of the football quickly.
Fortunate that that ball rolled out of bounds. Tuck that ball under your arm, young man.
That's not a loaf of bread.
That's right. Get it in there and lock it up. So it'll be first and 10 from the 34 of Seattle, as Deems May already has a touchdown to his credit from 17 yards, much of it on his own. Fire and vinegar. Can I clean that up a little bit? Spit and vinegar. Effort to get it into the end zone. Here's a pass to Ronnie Harris up near the 40, and then goes against the tide, and finally is a shorter gain, now about the 37-yard line, where he is hit by Richard Jones, who's played a lot of this ball game at cornerback, also Derwin Gray. Ronnie with three receptions, averaging almost 9 yards per catch in the preseason, coming into tonight's encounter. Back in 94, he first came out to the Northwest again after his college years in Oregon. He originally was back with New England. Former trackster and speedster has played well, and looks like he'll be returning punts for the 97 season and some wide receiver work. Second and 7, the screen to Broussard. There's the first down in the Colt territory and out of bounds. Jon Kitna just keeps making things happen as Derwin Gray was able to find the bruiser.
I understand the game so much more, is the quote from Jon Kitna. What a perfect play to have on against a blitz. You see the linebacker come right up the middle. You just draw the defense to you. Now you just get the ball in the speedster's hand and let him do the rest.
And he comes up with 20 yards after the screen pass connection from Kitna. Oh, what a difference a summer makes in Europe. Back to pass on first and 5. Complete. Guess who? McKnight is at it again. Monty Montgomery, the rookie out of Houston, is able to get him out of bounds, but not until he gets down to the 11-yard line.
Getting that little token fake, not much of a run fake, but John brings the receiver back. McKnight comes back. As you see, Buchanan falls down.
17-yard play.
You watch. Look at the protection up front. Greg Bladorn.
There's nobody there to block, Sam. They're down him, too. Pass complete and out of bounds to Eddie Goins out of North Carolina. Tim McTyre down to the 3 deeps now, a former BYU Cougar on this tackle. Last New Year's Day. Second down at 23. Back down 21. That's got room. Shoves it outside to Drew Innocent. Slides his way over to the 33-yard line and out of bounds. He's stopped by Clarence Thompson. Again, a rookie out of Knoxville College, but actually was a 2-year starter for Michigan before making the transfer.
And the pocket kind of breaks down. Jon Kitna's not comfortable. He breaks it, but then all of a sudden he says, "Hey, dude, you're a better runner than I am. Take it and go."
Boy, that almost looked like a knee injury. He went down a little strangely, but it seems to be all right. Third down and 10 for Drew Innocent, and the Seahawks need to get up to the 44-yard line of Seattle. And from the shotgun. Got a man. Did he hold on?
Yes,
he did. Eddie Goins with a terrific grab. Rico Clark was there defensive. But talk about concentration by the third-year youngster from North Carolina State. The all-time leading receiver for the Tar Heels.
Bob Rutkowski would love to keep 6 receivers because they run so much 4 wide, but Jon Kitna just gets sandwiched. Watch the concentration right here as the ball kind of slides through Rico Clark's hands.
Yep.
And Eddie just pins it on his shoulder pad. Versus $40 million generated in the stadium in Dallas.
First down and 5. Jon going for it. Davis. Kyrie rambles down to the 15-yard line. Jones. Do you get the feeling Richard Jones won't be employed much longer in the NFL?
Makes it tough, but again, you see, it's a crossing pattern. Lead the receiver away from the defense and let them make their move, make the speed. And Tyree Davis just goes against the football. Looks like they've done that once or twice before.
Yeah. Nice. Play good for 27 yards, Sam.
And a nice outside move.
And they will indeed go for it with Steve Ocheckett. Reggie Brown in the backfield. Again, Wilson in motion. And it'll be Kitna. And with the surge of the offensive line, it's Pater behind Greg Loader in the center.
So they've been working on that play all training camp long. They finally got it down. Jon Kitna, just fall forward. Number 60, I'm going for a piggyback ride.
His average carry right now is at about 6.3 as Jon Kitna is in the ballgame at quarterback. So Bruiser's getting a lot of yards when he carries it.
See Jon Kitna, 272 yards.
Yeah, he ran the table again last week going 8 for 8. He's done it twice, 14-14 against Minnesota. Toss sweep. And Broussard eyed up to midfield, very close to the first down at the 50-yard line. Roger Jones on the tackle, the left cornerback. It could have been worse. Kitna rolling out, and he's got Reggie Brown. And he's got Deems May blocking in front. Couldn't quite get to the man he wanted to, but Reggie wasn't going to wait and got it down inside the 35-yard line where he's hit by former Ohio State Buckeye Steve Tovar, number 58.
Play action pass definitely fools the Bengal defense. Reggie Brown comes out the backside completely untouched. Jon Kitna on the bootleg. Reggie brings it back to the middle, finds a little bit of a seam. Get about 4 more yards.
16 yards all told for Reggie, who's knew how to score touchdowns at Fresno State, to say the least. He's got 22 yards on 3 carries. Kitna to throw and complete down at the 5-yard line to Deems May, the tight end. And systematically, the Seahawks are doing a number on the Cincinnati reserves. Look at the smile. Deems May, 2 TDs this year.
Again, they do it with a play-action pass. He fakes the lead draw to Steve Broussard and then throws the outside curl to Deems May.
3rd and goal from the 4 as Bruiser goes out to the left side. Throws inside. Touchdown goes to Deems May. And the Seahawks back up tight end now as 3 touchdown receptions. As a Seahawk in preseason.
And Jon Kitna has 4 TD passes.
Yeah.
Again, it's the quick pass. He's looking at the tight end all the way. He sees a little bit of a seam. Oof. And just drills the football in there.
Threading of the needle. Here in the pros, you've got to hit the hole so much harder and faster than college ball. Lob across the middle, complete 5 of 5 as Tyree Davis, his old World Football League teammate, brings it down against Lott. Anthony Lott.
And look at the protection Jon Kitna gets as Bruiser steps up, blocks Bo Orlando. The safety coming in allows Jon Kitna the time to throw the little in route to Tyree Davis.
Play good for 20 yards as Tyree is again making things happen. And he may become more and more an important Seahawk with the injuries to Galloway and James Bush in motion. Looking across the middle. Touchdown, Cincinnati. With the lead. Duffy's kick is good. And it is 28-24 Cincinnati with 1:42 to go. So here's Doug Pelfrey as Tyree Davis will be back to. Oh, they're going to go with a short little chip shot. And it's Frank Beatty again. No. I think it's Ronnie Lee who finally holds on to it. Frank saying, I got one, I want more. And he's up to just beyond the 30-yard line with 1:37 to go. And the A.H. Belo Corporation. 1st and 10. Complete to Tyree Davis up to the 36-yard line, short of the first down with 1:29 to go. The clock continues to run. Stopped by Corey Sawyer. Davis shining tonight as his star gets brighter and brighter. Minute 19 to go. Kitna looking right. Swings it outside. Pass again complete. Good for the first down to Eddie Goins as they're up to the 45-yard line. Roger Jones stops it. Clock still moving, Sam. A minute two, a minute one. They need a touchdown as they're down by four. Across the middle, complete down to the 36-yard line. Jon Kitna finds Eddie Goins and another first down as the clock is stopped.
They call timeout to go to the sideline and talk and kind of regroup. He ran three successive plays. Eddie running that post pattern again. Little outside dip. You have Deems May keeping Sam Shade on the inside to strong safety to give Jon Kitna a throwing lane. That's a pass that Steve Largent caught a lot of, made a lot of catches out on that route.
They got it a lot of times.
A first and 10. Real show on the road.
Yeah. And a flag. As I believe it might be delay of game.
For the snap. False start.
No, excuse me. Can't be that. They had the clock run.
5 yards.
False start on James Atkins. 51 seconds remaining. First and 15. Throwing deep, complete, should have the first down depending where they mark it as he's down to the 24-yard line. Tyree Davis, and the clock is stopped again. Corey Sawyer on the tackle. Tyree.
He goes down and runs just a simple curl route. Finds the hole in the defense. Jon Kitna is looking to his left the whole way. Sees that, throws the football to Tyree Davis.
42 on the game clock.
They were running sort of a double zone. There was no one to threaten the flat, so Corey Sawyer stayed right with Tyree Davis.
Davis' third catch. This last one good for 23 yards. Hey, there's Brian in the very back. Brian Blades listening in. Everybody there. John Freeze, Mike Pritchard. And Jon Kitna is going to do this sometime on a full-time basis. Can't say enough, though, about what Sam mentioned earlier is how it's rubbing off the knowledge he's gaining from Freeze and Warren Moon.
He was kind of in awe thinking about playing catch while they were over in Cheney, you know, playing catch with Warren Moon. He says, Warren's still thinking, but pretty soon I'm going to start picking his brain.
First and 10. Throw it right. Davis trying to get out of bounds. They say keep the clock running. He's down to the 19 with 34 seconds remaining. Clock still running. No huddle. What great training for Jon Kitna and his receivers. 25 seconds and stops the clock with the throw to the ground. 24 seconds remaining. Third down and 5 from the 19. On the ground. Should have the first. And a timeout is called. There's the Z-man.
Yeah, you can always tell that he's got that distinguishable do.
Look at that do.
Yeah.
It's about an inch and a half longer than when he was playing.
Yeah. I wonder if he's got porcupine in the genealogy there.
First and 10 from the 14-yard line. Kitna trying to find the end zone. Throws incomplete. Trying to go to Ronnie Harris.
Anthony Lott is the one providing the coverage on Ronnie Harris, making it a difficult throw because Jon Kitna has to get it up and over Lott and yet keep Ronnie Harris in bounds to get the reception.
Tell you something, Ronnie doesn't often miss, though, a pass like that. He is exceptional when it comes to concentrating on that ball. 14 seconds to go, second and 10 from the 14. Looking into the end zone. Touchdown,
yes,
Deems May. He got it. Deems May with his second touchdown reception of the evening, and the Seahawks retake the lead with 6 seconds remaining. Jon Kitna, you are something else, youngster. There's John now, a 14-yard pass play. The Deems May, who now has 4 touchdown receptions in the preseason.
Did you see that smile on Dennis Erickson's face,
yeah,
too?
Yeah, and you don't see those very often. Preseason or not, this man is lighting him up. Beautiful pass and good recovery by May to curl around and get the reception.
Well, it was heads-up play on the part of May because linebacker Tim Terry did not see Deems May coming around behind him. He was just kind of drifting, getting ready to come up if Jon Kitna ran. And John throw the curl in behind.
And Sam, like you said, we may not see much of Jon Kitna this year, but what a great way to leave good memories in your coach's minds as the kick is good by Todd.
Good afternoon, everyone. Don Cricky with Jim Mora. The last time these teams played in October, it was a track meet with Seattle winning 45-34. But now there's a changing of the guard at quarterback for the Seahawks. The oldest quarterback in the league, Warren Moon, is on the bench with bruised up ribs. And Jon Kitna, who's never thrown a pass in a regular season game in the NFL, will start. But he's an exciting guy, Jim. Had a great preseason.
Right, as you said, Don, he's going to throw his first regular season NFL pass today. He's smart, mobile, and has a good arm. Bob Gronkowski, the offensive coordinator, told us he's got kind of a magic about him, but Gronkowski has no idea how he's going to play today. He's very popular with his teammates, and they're really pulling for him.
Kitna, you see in action here, was the most valuable player in the World League Championship game, quarterbacking Barcelona to the league title.
Well, you know what? I think they're going to do something that's going to keep it simple. For Kitna, I wouldn't surprise seeing him keep the ball, running a bootleg, a sprint out pass, something like that.
That's what he does. He swings the ball out in front for help, and he's ahead for a Seahawks first down.
Pass is complete.
Again, they go with three wide receivers. We'll see what kind of a throw he has here on third down and short. Here comes the rush. They give him time. He makes the connection. That's Galloway on the run. Joey Galloway loses a shoe and takes it all the way down inside the 25-yard line. He'll spot him out of bounds right at the 26. Actually, somebody lost his muff.
Earlier in the game, Don, they brought Albert Lewis off the slot. You're going to see him coming in from the outside, and he got a sack on Kitna. That time, he did the same blitz. He lined up on the slot, came from the outside, but the left tackle, Jones, got out there and blocked him, gave Kitna time to throw, and he hit Galloway on that crossing route.
By Jay Bellamy. 14-3 Raiders. Kitna fired. What a throw. He's on target, and on the run is Mike Pritchard. It's a foot race. They're going to get him, but all the way down to the 25-yard line he goes as Kitna stands in and throws a beauty to the streaking Mike Pritchard.
Kitna is getting a little pressure right here, but he hangs in there tough. Watch him right there. A little play-action fake to Smith.
61
people
yards.
All around him right there. Pretty good rush by the Raiders, but he makes a nice throw there to Pritchard. Pritchard just breaks it off on a little bit of a shallow post route. It's a good throw by Kitna. You know, one of the things that Bob Gronkowski, the coordinator, the offensive coordinator, says is that the Raiders are having a tough time covering people. We're going to try to take advantage of it.
It was stopped. But now the rain has stopped. Here comes Orlando Truitt with the touchdown reception, running the kickoff back, and the ball is on the field, it looks like. The Seahawks say they have it. They're quite sure of it. But you never know until the striped shirt says yes.
Like we've mentioned before, there's a lot of wrestling around that goes out underneath that pile, and well, the Seahawks got it.
If the Seahawks can get it in the end zone after this turnover, this could be a whole different game. Right now, the Raiders in command 21-3. Kitna with a quick drop, throws an out pattern, throws it well. Ball is taken by McKnight. He's down inside the 30-yard line and close to a first down. So it looked like they knew right where they wanted to go on that first time he was going to throw the ball, right to a quick timing pattern.
Right, and right here he knows exactly how many yards Knight's going to run before he does his out route, and Kitna was actually maybe just a hair slow there, but pretty good throw for a young quarterback, and that's a tough pattern to defend, and it's a pretty easy pattern to complete. Yes, I think how you mentioned earlier, his stats in the preseason, he was 42 of 51, five touchdowns, one interception for a quarterback rating of 125. Now, if he had those kind of stats now, he'd be the leading passer in the National Football League. But again, it's a big difference between playing against starters and backups that some of them won't even make the team.
Kitna made the team, though, as the third quarterback. Here's a throw and a kick to Pritchard, the former All-American from Colorado. Makes the grab at the 13-yard line. James Trapp levels him hard, but it is a first down for the Seahawks.
Well, again, as we mentioned a number of times, Kitna continues to show good poise and confidence here. This is a little bootleg fake by him, and they were going to move him around. They felt like this was one of the things they needed to do differently with him as opposed to Warren Moon, with bootlegs and kind of a controlled sprint out, move him in the pocket so he couldn't just stand back there and drop back action and take hits.
for a first down and seven for a touchdown. Here's a timing throw. Wide open is Joey Galloway. And his 61st catch of the season is for his 10th touchdown of the year. As all of a sudden, Kitna's confidence is sky high, beating Albert Lewis.
You know, Galloway runs a nice route here. There he is at the top, at the left side of your screen. No, I'm sorry, that was the outside receiver. Galloway came from inside, and Albert Lewis again had decent coverage, but it was a heck of a throw by Kitna.
More than any team in football history, the Seahawks have had good fortune with free agent quarterbacks. Jim Zorn, a free agent, he was a great one. Then David Craig, another free agent. And now free agent Jon Kitna might be the man of the future.
He sure might be, and that's an excellent point, Don, about Zorn and Craig. Both those guys undrafted, probably not given much of a chance to even make the team when they came to the Seahawks. I know David Craig.
On the defense, number 91. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
I know David Craig wasn't given any chance to make the team because I was coaching with the Seahawks when he came in as a rookie free agent. Well, really, we just brought him in and signed him to be an extra camp arm so we wouldn't wear out Zorn's arm and the other two quarterbacks we had. He ends up making the team and still playing.
18 years later. You have a storied tradition in Seattle, coaching at UW and with the Seahawks. First down and five after the call against the Raiders. Kitna stands in, dumps it over the middle. Chris Warren fielding the ball beautifully. Came to the wrong side. And the sure-handed Warren, with his 45th catch of the year, is ahead for a Seahawk first down. Jon Kitna's wife, Jennifer, on the left there, and his dad, Martin, must be feeling better about things.
They don't. His wife might be thinking about Jordan, their young 6-week-old son.
Second down, yard to go. Kitna, timing throw. Good throw. He gets it to Pritchard. Pritchard, a schooled receiver, running precise routes, turning out and Kitna's moving that tight spiral right on his numbers.
They're doing a nice job with the quick passing game, the out routes, the hooks, the little dump off routes to the backs, the second half, and Kitna's doing a much better job the second half than he did the first half.
Sprinter speed, he's been the lone back most of the game. Here's a throw and a catch straight down the field. They go to the tight end, Deems May. And May shows, if you throw it to me, I can get it for you. He's ahead for a first down.
Kitna did a nice job here because he saw Frederickson come up on the right side. He saw 43 Lorenzo Lynch come up the right side. He knew that they were going to be blitzing with Frederickson and Lynch, so that puts man-on-man coverage on the tight end. So he knew Deems May was going to be locked up man-on-man against the Raider defensive back, and he hit Deems May for the first down.
His young understudy steps center stage today. Kitna, near side, makes the connection. Big Max Strong running hard, crosses midfield. Second down and eight. He got ahead for a gain of about 7 yards.
It looks to me, Don, like Kitna is doing a much better job the second half of handling the Raider blitzes. Here again, they're going to blitz their linebackers. They're going to try to put pressure. You're going to see 55, James Folston coming off the left side. You're going to see 53, Rob Fredrickson coming on the right side. And Kitna is not bothered now by the blitzes. He's keeping his poise back there and hitting the open guy. Doing a much better job of handling that this half than he did the first half.
Very important down coming up now for Jon Kitna and the Seahawks. Third down, they need two. He looks, he throws, he makes the connection to the 38-yard line, triggering the ball into Joey Galloway against airtight coverage by Perry Carter.
You talk about sticking it in there in a critical down. They had to have that as third and three. Good coverage by the Raiders. He sticks it in there. He knows right where he's going, a three-step drop. Look at that. It had to be right on target to be a completion, and he did it.
If it's good, the Seahawks take the lead. He's into it. He's got enough distance. And he is down the middle. A 49-yard field goal by Todd Peterson. Sends a Dennis Erickson into a happy mode. And the Seahawks rally back with 19 unanswered points to take the lead in the second half. They were on cruise control, it looked like.
going up against a young quarterback, Jon Kitna, a team that's been hurt tremendously by injuries, and with a 21.3 lead, and then to lose this thing, this is not going to be good for the Raider organization, an organization that's suffered a lot of turmoil this year and certainly this week.
So Al Davis, a guy whose team has known great success in the throes of dismal seasons, they'll now fall to 4-11. And Jon Kitna and the other victorious Seahawks roundly congratulated. One thing about changing coaches, and the speculation surrounds a lot of coaches about what's going to happen after the season, is you're starting all over. You go back to square one. People think you fire a guy and bring in somebody else. You know, some of the greatest success stories in this league were built around coaches who were dismal failures, or so it seemed early.
And of course, Jon Kitna is the backup quarterback. Did a terrific job in the World League, had an unbelievable preseason, and then you saw what he did last week against the Raiders in some terrible condition. Now keep in mind, the Seahawks were down 21-3 at the half. Kitna led them back to a victory with a team that could have just said, hey, look, it's over, the heck with it, let's go on and get ready for next year. But this football team didn't quit.
Kitten to throw over the middle. Lester Crumpler, the tight end, with his first catch out to the 16-yard line.
Michael, the thing I like about Jon Kitna is the way he does get rid of the football. When you talk to the coaches, Bob Rutkowski and Dennis Erickson, they'll say, he's an athlete, he moves around very well, he makes very quick decisions with the football, and he gets it out in a hurry. And that's exactly what you're looking for in an offensive quarterback.
Played at Central Washington, really the only reason they knew about him is because Dennis Erickson went to see his nephew play. James Christian was on the same team, and they got a look at him. Kitna play action goes to Pritchard. And Pritchard out to the 24-yard line, that could be the first down. You would think with all the scouting that's done in the NFL, all the countless numbers of dollars that are spent, you'd know about any player in any school, but they were the only ones who really worked him out, knew anything about him. They were going to draft him, but he just kept falling through the cracks, so they signed him as a free agent.
Well, I think also, too, Mike, you got to keep in mind, there's 30 teams. You're going to need 90 quarterbacks. 90 quarterbacks will wind up dressing on professional teams now.
Kitna, nice throw, great catch by Pritchard out to the 43.
Darnell Walker could not have been much closer to try to make a play. Mike Pritchard does a good job at the line of scrimmage. That's where you win most routes. Now he makes a terrific play on the ball and decides to get on down. A good throw. I've been watching Warren Moon throw spirals. What a fingertip catch that was. I think that's going to change in the playoffs.
Second and 11. Kitna unloads. Crumpler with another tackle. He's got a first down to the 43-yard line. Well, you got to like the way Kitna gets rid of the ball in a hurry.
But he sees things. And I think vision is very critical for a quarterback. You have to be able to see somebody coming and unload the football and know where you want to go with it. Very bright young man. Here he sees the blitz coming up outside. Hits the tight end. Perfect.
And there aren't many young quarterbacks who see those things either.
No. And that's where the World League helps so much, Mike. And got to make Paul Allen very happy to see his football team performing this well.
Approaching the 7-minute mark in a game that Seattle has dominated. Kitten again, another short set, a quick pass and a completion. Got this one to Ronnie Harris, only his fourth catch of the season. First and 10, Seattle. Kitna, boy, does he look good. Crumpler just driving for extra yardage. You ran right over Brett Maxey.
You know, you shouldn't be surprised to see Jon Kitna have the ability to be able to complete passes like this. He went through the preseason and completed 82.5% of them. He's 6-for-6 tonight for 75 yards. Again, gets the ball out in a hurry. Defenders have a very difficult time getting their hands up to knock it away when you get the ball out that quick.
Crumpler, an enormous tight end, 6'6", 260. Third and 14. Kitna has Broussard in the flat. makes the first man miss. Broussard inside the 10-yard line. Boy, and Jim Schwantz just threw a whiff at him.
We talked about the change-up ability of San Francisco's backs. When Steve Broussard goes in, he has that same kind of speed and acceleration to make people miss. This one's for the fans. Fourth down and four. Kitna's numbers.
Couldn't be much better. All he needs to top it off the touchdown pick. Here comes the blitz. Kitna unloads. Get away with one hit. Ozzie Smith in the hole on a hard line drive.
Oh, what a catch. That's when you know it's going good. This is when it's going good. Watch Joey Galloway. It's thrown way back to his left. He reaches out with one hand, with the glove hand, and then catches it and brings it in. I think he's just going to be a real special talent. Whoa! Let me lay that out there and bring it on in. Last week, no, didn't make a call.
Kitna, quarterback sneak. Touchdown. So Jon Kitna comes in and is perfect. That's why he's got the big smile.
Again, the offensive line just gets under the defensive line of the 49ers. You see that surge in the middle for Jon Kitna. A touchdown.
Pretty good 2 weeks in that young man's life.
Yeah.